Lean Construction Education Enabled by Internet of Things, and is presented by Silvia Mastrolembo Ventura, if I know. Perfect.
Hi,
the floor is yours. Thank you.
Okay, can you see the screen, right?
Yes.
Okay, good morning, everyone. I'm Silvia Mastrolembo Ventura, and I'm a postdoc at the University of Brescia in Italy in the field of digital innovation for process engineering in construction. And today I'm going to present a case study that was developed within the framework of an international collaboration. And it is related to the development of an educational game for lean construction education enabled by Internet of Things. And first I will briefly introduce you to the motivation behind this research. And then I will describe you the architecture of the educational game, as well as the methodology applied and the results obtained in this preliminary step. Finally, I will describe you some ideas for future works. First of all, the motivation behind this research lies in an interest about how game learning has the potential, game-based learning, has the potential to improve the education and the performance of engineering students. And in fact, the research has found also in our context that educational game enables students to engage with the learning material and allow them to explore and interact with desired concepts effectively. In fact, combining theory and practice, serious games can support teaching them real processes in a simple way, helping to transfer methods into practice. And within that context, we decided to adopt, as I said, an educational game as a learning tool for construction engineering students in order to introduce them to the basic concepts of lean construction. And I will then briefly define what lean construction is. And moreover, we have to say that the construction industry is currently going through a significant digital transition. And for that reason, we wanted also to use the educational game to evaluate how students deal with the digital technologies, such as in this case, Internet of Things, applying them to lean construction concepts and processes. So what is lean construction, first of all? Lean construction is a methodology that we can adopt in construction management in order to minimize waste and maximize the value during the construction phase of a facility. In particular, we have three elements that guide research and practice in the field of construction management, and they are time, budget, and quality of a facility. And in particular, during the construction phase, in order to optimize time, reduce cost, and increase the quality of the final building facility or infrastructure facility, we need to manage in an effective way materials, workforce, and equipment. Moreover, lean construction also encouraged collaboration and cooperation between all the stakeholders involved during the construction phase of a facility in order to share information effectively to deal with unexpected issues that may occur on site during the construction phase. On the other hand, as I said before, construction sites are becoming smarter workplaces. For that reason, automation and digital tools may be used to improve the construction management. And in particular, in this case, we took into account Internet of Things concepts and how they can be introduced for improving the quality in producing, but also in sharing and managing actual data coming from the construction sites in order to support the decision-making process. And in particular, we can use the sensors to obtain information automatically to supervise, for example, the progress of the work or to manage health and safety of resources on site. For that reason, these are the main basic concepts we wanted to teach to the students that are involved in this educational game. And for that reason, we decided to develop the first version of an educational game that combines both lean construction concepts that are important from the management of point of view and IoT concepts that are part of the digital transition that is currently going ongoing for the construction industry. We wanted to introduce both the concepts to the students like they would experience later in their professional careers. In particular, we decided to use IoT in order to automatically collect time and location-related data on site during the play of the game, so to improve decision-making. I will describe you the architecture of the educational game in order to simplify construction sequences by facilitating the simulation. We decided not to take into account the construction of buildings or infrastructures, but we used the Lego kits for the construction of 6 airplanes, including the instructions of the Lego kits. And in the game, we also the game also requires 4 players. Each player represents a different trade. Each trade will have the task of building a specific sequence of the airplane. And moreover, each airplane is built in its own workstation. The game is made of 3 rounds. And in particular, only 1 player per workstation is permitted, forcing the others to wait in the warehouse area, which is a material storage area. And while the first player can flow freely in the first round, other players leave the warehouse with the necessary material to complete their work sequence only if the preceding player has returned. Upon the return of the last player, the game ends, but also there is a quality control check of the result of the building of each airplane in order to evaluate the quality of the final product. As I said, the game is organized in 3 rounds, and in round 2 and round 3, we change something in the methodology of the gaming. For example, both the warehouse and the workstation are simulated in rooms and corridors of a building floor. So in round 2, we decided to reduce the traveling time, which is the time to move from the warehouse where materials are located to the workstations, changing the location of the warehouse that you can see in green in the images in the right part of the screen. So in the second round, the warehouse is closer to the center of gravity of the different 6 workstations. In round 3, we wanted to implement an interruption to the production cycle. For example, in the workstation 6, we implemented unexpected events. In this case, you can see one of the players experiencing a low visibility condition in one of the workstations. Of course, the player was not informed about this change in the gaming, and he was surprised by that, but he had to perform the same activities that were previously supposed to be performed in the workstation, but in different conditions. So what we wanted to evaluate were basically this type of data, the working time, so the time that each player spent in the workstation to perform the construction sequences, travel time, so the time that they need to move from the warehouse to the workstations, waiting time, so the time they needed to wait for a previous player to come back to the warehouse before they can go to the workstations to do their own construction sequences, and then the time from start to completion of the 6 airplanes in each round. Moreover, the sequence of building all the airplanes, so the 6 airplanes, simulates a repetitive construction process, which is linked to the standardization concept of lean construction. In fact, we wanted also to underline how learning and repetitiveness could accelerate the construction procedure, but at the same time, we wanted to evaluate how incidents on site may have, or better, unexpected events may have an impact on the construction activities. From the technological point of view, We decided to collect data both manually and automatically in order to compare the collected data, also because the IoT platform was still under development by the University of Bochum in Germany that participated in the development of the case study. And in particular, we started using Bluetooth low energy beacons, but then because of some errors in data collection, we decided to replace them with the near field communication tags. And in particular, the data collected that are related to time, location, and light intensity were collected in a customized application for mobile devices. An important novelty of this work was also that for the first time, location data of players were available in real time in a building information model of the building floor where the simulation took place. The educational game was tested in the first version three times in Germany, in Bochum, in Brescia, so in Italy, and one of the co-authors, Jochen Taser, had the opportunity to test the game also in Hong Kong. And in particular, 12 architectural and civil engineering students participated, supervised by 4 graduate students and 2 researchers. We can have a look at the learning curves in order to evaluate how lean construction concepts were considered and developed and the results of the game on some of the concepts that I introduced you about in the beginning of my presentation. First, as you can see, we compared both automatically collected and manual collected data because we wanted, as I told you before, validate also the IoT platform that was still under development. So we noticed some errors in the data collection at least 3 times, but this is related to the technological point of view. Another thing that we can see is that each play of the series game at different locations in the world showed a consistent reduction of total work time to complete airplanes at the workstations. And the overall production time, except in the respective first play rounds, has been steady and similar in the 3 times we tested the games. So the time to complete each play round of the series game steadily decreased over the play time, except in Bochum, and I will then show you briefly why. And in fact, the curves started steep and became quite constant in the latter workstations or during the third play round. And this is mainly due to the reduction of the required work time to complete the task. And in fact, the players remembered the assembly steps. They didn't need to look at the instructions anymore. And the learning process of the procedures by the players is evident in the learning curves. Finally, it is important also to highlight some additional considerations. As I already mentioned before, in workstation 6, in the third round, we included some unexpected events, like the low visibility conditions. And while in this, if we look at Bochum data, for example, this corresponded to 45% of increased completion time for this airplane, and the low visibility had an impact on productivity also in Brescia and in Hong Kong. We can also see that the slowest building times are always related to the assembly of the first few planes in the first play rounds. So this demonstrates also how experience matter. I know that my time is almost done, so I'm moving to the conclusions. As I told you during the presentation, students learned IoT and lean construction basic principles through this educational game and a self-developed technology platform. And this is just the first step in providing construction engineering students with digital means that they were unaware of or had not used before. The platform allowed recording and analyzing data that were previously unavailable, and the lessons learned, and also the progress curves, the efficiency monitoring, and the observation of the impact of unforeseen incidents were finally quantifiable. As future works, we could suggest first to engage a larger number of students in the test So to generalize some of the data that we collected with TIS first case study. And also we need a more reliable location tracking technology, so that is currently under development. But also we could suggest two other topics. First, the use of a prediction algorithm to forecast and eliminate incidents before they happen, not to evaluate what happens after an incident. And also an interesting aspect could be the evaluation of the student resistance in adopting technologies in their professional careers. Thank you. And if you have any question, I'm happy to answer.
Silvia, thank you very much for your presentation. Very interesting work. I think we have gone out of time, so you have used also the time for discussion session. So I think we have to go to the next session, because okay. The following coffee break is very short.
You can write me an email if you have any questions also.
Perfect. Thank you very much again.
Thank you.
Then we go to the last presentation of this session. That is a conceptualization of hypersituation as a result of